What's up, builders? So a couple days ago, ElevenLabs announced Scribe, which they are claiming is the world's most accurate speech-to-text model. So I wanted to film this quick video on this endpoint just to showcase something that may be useful to you. So the first part is you can jump into the ElevenLabs dashboard and they have speech to text down here, the products. This is me kind of testing this out here, but you can click this transcribe file button and upload up to 1,000 meg. Now for the $5 pricing plan, I'm not going to go through all the different plans, but for this kind of base $5, you only get 30 minutes out of this dashboard here, which is not that much, but you do get 12 hours inside of the API. So where is my docs here? So I'm going to show you just very, very basic workflow inside of N8N that I put together here. When you click, it's going to download an MP4 that I have sitting in Google Drive. I've got like a 7-minute video here, which is just a tutorial of a piece of software. We hit the endpoint for speech to text, and then I put it into a Google Doc. So I'm going to click test workflow and let this run, so you guys can see what the results are as it comes through. So if I double click download file here, file download, and then from the list, I have my Google Drive connected here. This is the title of the MP4. You can see it's about 45 meg, and I just got the check mark that this completed successfully. So let's go through the transcript curl here. And one of the things you can do in NAN is just copy this and then paste it right into the HTTP node. But we need two headers. We need an API key. We need content type multi-part form data. N8N actually does not require you to insert this because they will detect this themselves. The next two important things are model ID, and I'm actually gonna zoom in here. Model ID and file, obviously the file for transcription. For model ID, one thing to note, you need to change this double quote model underscore ID and replace it with Scribe V1. Now, this is the only version available at the moment, but they are basically using this as a placeholder to let you know, hey, more of these are going to come through. So if we go back to our endpoint here, here is the URL that we're hitting, which is speech to text. I have my API key, which I will delete after this video. And then for the body, we're going to toggle this on content type form data, parameter type form data, name model underscore ID. And here's where we put scribe underscore V1. And what we're passing for the file is an N8N binary file that we downloaded from Google Drive. The name is file and the input data name is data. So if we look at this, we get a successful request here. You can see it's part, this JSON is huge because it parses each individual word in the transcription. But if you scroll back to the top and in the text here, this is everything. So if I come back out and I double click on this Google Doc, here's my URL to the specific Google Doc here. And the text that I am passing, if I look at the schema from the HTTP request, I'm just dragging text into this block, which is JSON.txt. So if I pull up the blank document that I had before, we get this transcription. So we browse the URL, which is this, yada, yada. And it's one page because it's only about 7 minutes. Now I will say, me testing this out, this API endpoint at the moment is only taking videos up to 1 hour in length. So if you have a longer video, you are going to need to chunk it into bite-sized pieces. And in addition to that, you also have a lot of these new endpoints in Scribe that you can particularly do some useful things. You can dub over videos, you can create voices, all of the things here in the docs, which I will link in the description if you want to check it out. I'm going to keep this one short and sweet. This is ElevenLabs Scribe. Start transcribing some things. Peeps. Catch y'all later. Peace.